Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DBC Technology. And today we're gonna take the G5 Ultra Turret and we're gonna put it outside and compare it to the other Ubiquiti cameras. So this is part two of our G5 Turret video. If you didn't see the first one where I compared the G5 Ultra Turret and the G5 Ultra Dome, we'll put a link in the description. I'll put a card up in the corner there for you to take a look at that video. I would go back to that one and probably watch that one first. So I would definitely look at the beginning of that video where we go over the mounting and the mounting options and the question and answer section of that. That way you'll get a lot of those 8 questions answered. So that being said, we put all the outdoor cameras on a test board. We put it up and today we're gonna test it both in the daytime and the nighttime, and we're also gonna test the audio. So without any further ado, let's jump into the software and start taking a look at the cameras. You can see here, I've got 7 cameras up here. That's gonna be the G5 Turret Ultra. That's going to be the G5 Bullet. That is gonna be the G5 Flex. It's going to be the AI Bullet, the AI Pro, the G4 Bullet, and the G5 Pro with image enhancer. Let me go ahead and put all these into high quality so we get the best possible image. And I will tell you right off the bat, the G5 Turret and the G5 Flex, so the two on the left-hand side, I think these are the most comparable two images. And I think they are very, very nice images. What you're getting with the Turret is you're getting the width that you're getting here on the G5 Flex. You can see in both of these, the silver car is here, and in the Bullet, which is got a little bit more tele zoom on it, you are not seeing that much of the parking lot. So first and foremost, I think that probably the biggest competitors for this camera is gonna be locations where you put a G5 Bullet and locations where you would put a G5 Flex. And so you can see just right off the bat, there is a width advantage for the G5 Turret over the G5 Bullet. And I think if you look into the images, the G5 Turret and the G5 Flex are almost indistinguishable from each other. You know, it's hard to really notice anything in either of these images that is like glaringly different. Like I'm looking at like the lens flare on this car over here, maybe handled a little bit better with the G5 Ultra than the G5 Flex, but probably not enough that, would make a difference to me. I mean, really, it's hard on these images to decipher any real advantage of one over the other. I will say, you know, motion and getting the vehicles, they both are doing a great job there. Rendering colors look pretty similar. You know, sometimes with the AI versus the non-AI ones, you see a color difference, like over here with the AI Pro versus the G5 Pro, there is this kind of, the AI Pro almost has this kind of lighter look to it. These are all just so similar in the way they render. I think the reality of it is really gonna come down to what mounting options you want and what field of view you're looking at here. I'll go ahead and bring up the AI Bullet, which obviously, you know, brings us in with AI detections versus the G5 Bullet, and then the G4 Bullet, which is an older camera and still performing well. But you see here, and I'll show you an example of where, I mean, this sensor, and a little grainy when we start to zoom in, but it's also falling down when we get these kind of chromatic aberrations around a direct sunlight that you can see in the G5 Bullet. It's just rendering that better. And same thing with the Ultra. You're not getting those kind of purple fringes on those flares. Obviously the optical zoom with the G5 Bullet gives you more detail in that section of the zoomed in image than would a wider field of view. So you are giving up a little bit of detail resolution for a wider field of view. So that, you know, that's something to consider. As I go through the pros, I mean, the pros just, you know, they're in a whole nother league. We get the width that you get there, but this level of detail, and I don't know how the YouTube compression is going to affect things, but this level of detail is crazy. And I'm not even using the zoom feature here. If I wanted to zoom in on this stuff, that's not a direct and fair comparison. I know a lot of people wanted these cameras to be the high end, you know, higher megapixel cameras, but you know, I don't think that really is Unifi's intent here. I think what they were trying to do is really put together a camera system, a couple of cameras here that are really going to appeal to the mass market. And I think the Turret and the Dome, which is not in this example, really fit that bill. And you can see here with the G5, it's a little bit different look to the image, but it has that resolution and it's really, really amazing. So to everybody that asked about the comparison between the Turret and the Pros, I don't think that that's a fair comparison at all. I'll do them back to back. You know, this is a decent good image during the day, and you can see the fine detail down in these little bushes, but like when you go into the AI Pro and you look down there, it's almost like 3D, ultra sharp, HDR, crazy, beautiful. So, you know, with that, during the day, the considerations for me here are going to definitely be the field of view. So do I need, you know, am I an open, wide open area where I need to see more? If I do want more, I think the Flex and the turret are the better choices there. But if I had a narrowly defined area that I needed to take a close look at, I think the Bullet is the better form factor for there. So really, this is going to be a margin call for me in the, during the day. And I think the value of the two, the Flex and the turret at $129 is pretty high in this list. And I think my daytime go-to here would probably be the G5 Turret Ultra. So with that, let's go ahead and wait for it to get dark and we'll jump in and review these cameras tonight. All right, through the magic of YouTube, it is now nighttime and I've got Margaret and Sketch out there as my assistants driving around in the car real quick to kind of do a nighttime comparison. Very similar to the daytime comparison, though these cameras are so similar. So real quickly, I'll go through the turret. And obviously, you know, that's a really nice nighttime image there. I think there's some detail that I can see from pretty much anything I need to see in that image. We'll go ahead and compare that to the G5 Flex, which in this comparison I find to be its kind of main competitor. Very similar images. I mean, just very, very similar images. G5 Bullet, you know, it's obviously zoomed in a little bit, but you know, I just don't see that there's that much in any of these images. AI Pro. I find that both of the AIs are a little struggle. Well, I don't say struggle because that's a strong word. They're a little less strong in nighttime. You know, they're a little less sensitive at night, but not horribly so. I mean, the one camera here that's really fallen down for me is the G4 Bullet, though. You can just see how grainy it is. I think this is the camera, if it was up to me, that I would be replacing with the turret. I just think that the image there is so much nicer, and I really can't identify. That's a perfect example when Margaret's walking towards us here. Just how much clearer it is when she's coming towards us here, as opposed to the G4 Bullet. So I would, you know, I think they're all really comparable here. I would definitely say the one that I would replace is the G4 Bullet. And the other ones are just options for different mounting options and widths and quality. Obviously, if you want detections, the AIs are gonna be ones for you there. So let's real quickly show you the quality of the sensor without night vision on. Oh, I think I will tell you is in the turret here at the bottom, you are seeing a little bit of the next mount in the image there. And same thing with the G5 Flex, which, you know, probably does cause a little bit of something there, but I really don't think. I mean, they're both handling that really well. So I'm gonna go ahead and say, you know, you could see those there and that may affect it a little bit in that, but I don't think so. But yeah, again, they're all performing pretty well. But give me 2 seconds here. I'm gonna turn off IR on all of them and we will go to see what they look like in normal mode at night and how sensitive they are. One thing I will really want to mention really quickly, and this is maybe not in the version that you have in your system, but the new way to do the adjustment where you can just click on live view and the settings are right here. I know it's a small coding change, but the coder that put that in there is legend. This is such a nice way to come in and adjust the settings of the cameras instead of having to go in the device and find all the settings there. If you know that that's a real major upgrade and I'm really stoked. But now with the IR off, you can see how the images work in, you know, just no light. Now, what I will tell you, obviously, again, there's a lot of light in my parking lot. And if I turn on the two street lights that are in my parking lot that are off, these are really good images. But on the turret, let me just show you the green here on the DPC logo and take a look at that. I think of all of them, it's rendering that green the best. Flex is doing a decent job on it, but it's not quite as vividly green as it is on the turret. You can see on the Bullet, it's doing a decent job on it, but again, it's not quite as vividly green. The AI Bullet does a decent job, but it's a little bit more milky. And AI Pro, you know, man, AI Pro, wow, that's really pretty impressive on the AI Pro, as it should be, and the G5 Pro too. Pretty impressive green on the two of those. But, and you know, the G5 Pro, as well, has in it what they call color night vision, and that's turned on. So AI Pro does not have that. but it is, you know, it's doing a really nice job. The one again that I think that probably would be up for replacement is the G4. Man, it's really struggling. Let's just say you had a G4 at a location and you were thinking about upgrading it to a turret. Gee, look at how nice that turret looks there, man. Woo! Just a huge, huge upgrade. But as Margaret walks back through here, I will show you one thing about night vision, or just at night in general, without IR on, is movement of a human starts to get blurry. As you can see that it's really hard to identify faces and stuff. She looks blurry there. And, you know, she's going to look blurry in all of them. It's a little ghosting. It doesn't handle the movement very well. You can just see kind of it looks like a ghost melting there. Oh, man, that G4 really is struggles. You know, where that would work better for me in this parking lot is if I turned on the two street lights, and I probably would be able to use that. But I think putting them into IR mode is definitely the right solution here. Wow, you can really see the ghosting there. She walks on the AI bullet. But, you know, if you were going to run them in kind of this light mode at night, you can see that this G5 Turret Ultra sensor is doing a decent job of it at night. So it just looks like there's a bunch of different mounting options and widths for me here. I don't really see such a huge difference in each one of these cameras that I'm going to be drawn to one over the other. You know, for the G5 Flex and the G5 Turret to me are most comparable. Obviously, if I wanted the bullet form factor, the only one here that I would say is that needs to be replaced at this time is the G4 Bullet. But the others, you know, obviously the AIs get detections, and the G5 Pro has the enhancer and the floodlight. So it's a special case itself. At the $129 level, I think my choice at this point would be the turret, but it's not that big of a jump between the Flex and the Bullet. But with that, let's go ahead and jump into an audio test. We're gonna test how the microphones work in all the cameras. All right, so let's do a quick sound check. I've got Daniel out in front, so I am going to quickly, I'll turn on the audio on the G5 Turret, and we'll have Daniel talk a little bit. Go ahead, Daniel.
Ultra Turret testing, test. Hello.
Okay, so that's the G5 Turret. You can hear the traffic going by as well. Then I'm going to turn that off, and we'll do the G5 Flex. Okay, that sounds good, and we'll go ahead and do the G5 Bullet.
Bullet testing, G5 Bullet testing. Testing, hello.
All right, just for giggles, we'll go ahead and take the G4 Bullet and test it as well.
G4 Bullet testing, G4 Bullet. Testing, hello. G4 testing.
Perfect. And one last time, we will go through and we will do the G5 Turret just for one follow-up.
Turret testing. Hello. Turret testing. Turret testing. Hello.
Okay. Thanks so much, Daniel. For what that's worth, you know, I think they're all very similar there. I think the G5 Flex probably sounded best to me. It was a little loudest with the cars going by. So, you know, it's kind of your mileage may vary there, but I think the G5 Turret and the G5 Flex, again, are really, really close. Actually, you know, the G5 Bullet, which has gotten a little bit of ridicule, I think in that particular test, it was doing some good job with the noise cancellation. The background noise was muted a little bit, and Daniel sounded pretty good. So in my case, I really don't use the audio very often. I can't remember the last time I've ever gone back to hear anything. That being said, you know, that was a apples to apples comparison there in a relatively normal environment here. You got cars going by and somebody out front talking. So take that for what it's worth. And with that, let's jump into your questions. I already answered most of the questions about the turret in my previous video, so I'll put a link in the description down below and you can just go down to the questions section there. There's a index and you can just choose that section. But overwhelmingly, the most common question I got about the turret was about the flexibility and the mounting options. So I'm gonna do a quick overlay here. It's really nice system here. I think they really, really knocked it out of the park with this. You just simply twist the bottom base collar and it frees up the whole system, and you can do 360 pan. You can tilt it all the way back to 90 degrees. It goes down to about 15 to 20 degrees horizontal, but you can also rotate the camera inside of it. So if you're mounting it against a wall and you wanted to kind of look sideways, you can do that. So pretty much any orientation in a half dome, you can get this camera. It really is super easy. And the more that you twist the collar, the freer it gets, the tighter you make the collar, the more you do fine adjustments that have some resistance. So I think they knocked it out of the park with this mounting system. I think people are really gonna like it. The other question was about how big of a hole you need to cut to get the pigtail through. The actual housing for the pigtail is round on this one, which is a little bit nicer, and it goes through a 1-inch hole pretty easily. A lot of your exterior instances are probably gonna want that junction box to mount to. I also got a lot of questions about IR. I spent a lot of time last night kind of going through IR on all the different cameras. And to be honest, in my area, there really wasn't much IR difference in my parking lot between any of them. Now, somebody may test that in a really dark backyard and make a difference, but I turn them on, turn them off, and see if I could see any real difference. In my parking lot, there really was no difference. Hey, Future Clay jumping in one more time. I actually want to go into why we would actually want a turret. There are a couple of different reasons you would want a turret over the other form factors. First, the turret is a little bit more tamper-proof. You know, obviously, if you're having a bullet on the side of the building, you can take a pole and maybe push it to the other direction or kind of obstruct it. Whereas the turret is a little harder for somebody to kind of manipulate. Also, that brings up that it's a little bit more discreet. So it's easier to see a bullet on the side of a building than it is to see a turret. It's a little smaller. It's a little closer to the building. It's a little more tucked in. It looks like probably a different piece of equipment. You obviously know a bullet when you see it. That could be good. You may want people to see your bullet. Or your surveillance, or it may be bad and you don't want them to. So, you know, obviously you have both options there. The third is the weatherproofing. I think the turret and the bullet are very similar this way. You could throw this turret on the outside of the building and man, it's gonna be a tank. It's gonna sit there for forever. The Flex, on the other hand, needs the Pro Mount, which is another $12 to buy that Pro Mount to really make that weatherproof. And I don't think it's as kind of as rugged as this turret and the bullet are. So I just wanted to mention that really quickly. Those are the reasons I would choose the turret over the bullet or the Flex. The other question I got a lot was about AI. So the G4 and the G5 line get the introductory AI features. They get motion, person, vehicle, and animal detections. But if you want the higher end AI features like classification and recognition, you have to go to the AI series of cameras. All of the AI cameras, except for the 360, give you more insight into kind of what the classification of the vehicle is, color and description, like what type it is. And they also give you both license plate and facial recognition. So if you need AI features, the way I would do it, I would blend these cameras together. I would use the AI cameras like at entry points, front doors, back doors, in the driveway, where I needed to see facial recognitions or license plate detections. But the rest of the surveillance system may not need those features. And that's where I would put these other cameras like the G5 Flex, the G5 Bullet, and the G5 Ultra Turret. So basically you're getting the best of all worlds and you're doing it at the lowest possible budget. You know, who I think these cameras are for, I don't know that I necessarily run out to replace a G5, any of the G5 series, but the G4 cameras and before, I think this is a compelling upgrade. I think this is a great system. I think the versatility of being indoor and outdoor and the mounting system is going to be very, very popular. And along with the G4 Ultra Dome, I think Ubiquiti is going to have a hard time keeping these in stock. At the end of the day, everybody's been asking for a turret for a long time, and this is the camera that you've been looking for. So with that, if you see it in stock, I would highly suggest that you buy it because it won't be in stock for long. So we are going to be leaving the Ultra Turret and the Ultra Dome up in our office. If you have any questions or you want us to test anything, please leave that in the comments down below. If you like videos like this, we do them weekly, so please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.